Welcome in full course C++. This course is designed to understand the basic terminologies and concepts of C++. This course is specially designed for the beginners who try to understand the concepts of programming using C++. In this course, we will discuss and study the C++ from installation to its basic concepts, its structure detail, its components, the components of the C++ in detail, data types. So let's start from installation of Dev C++. We have to go to any browser available in your computer. Just go to google.com, right here, download Dev C++. The first link is from SourceForge. That will lead you how we can download Dev C++. Here is the download button to which we have to click for the download process of the Dev C++. Here is the link. Okay, in this machine or computer, the Dev C++ is already installed. So before consuming any time in discussion, we will go through the Dev C++. We have to just after installation go to start menu, type here Dev C++, press enter. The default Dev C++ interface will be appear. We can see here, this is the default Dev C++ interface. Basically, why we recommend Dev C++? This is the user friendly and provide much more flexible tools, and from beginner to advanced we can use Dev C++. Here is the fundamental options that are available in each and every Windows application. The first one is called file menu. From the top of the file menu, this is called title bar, which contains name of the application, and the in file menu, after the file menu, we have toolbars. Here some instant tools, and this is the sidebar, and this one last is the project area. Okay, for creating new project in Dev C++, we have to go to file menu. Here we can see here file menu. From file menu, we will go to a pop-up menu that is called new. In new menu, we will have to create or click on project option. The project dialog window will be appear here. From that point, we have to create, select console application. We can create C++ or C project from here, depending on the type of the project. We have to type here project name. Finally, we will click on OK. This is the process by which we can create an empty project in Dev C++. This project will be called console application, C++, or maybe type of C project. The entire line of codes and basic structure of Dev C++ and C++ is approximately same. We will discuss later on in this lectures. Okay, so proceed the similar process. We are going to create a C++ project. We are going to write here full course, the name of the project. Click on OK. Before going to the working area of the project or file, we have to save the project. This file is created successfully. That is, we can see here, that is named as main.c++. When we go to compile this code, we first of all to save the file that is defaultly named as main.c++. We will have to change this name. We can say that this is test file for our start project or first project. Okay, this is the default comment line. We will also discuss what are the comments, what are its meaning. Comment line, we are just removing this for the time being. We are adding a line that is called using name space std. This is the fundamental line for displaying output to the standard input and output device. which is called keyboard and mouse. So let's start discussing the entire line of codes. These three or four line of codes are already written, or can say that ready made, in every new project of C++ that will be created in Dev C++. So go to the code of lines and understand what is the meaning of each and every line in C++. The first line is called preprocessor directive. The second line is called namespace. Third line is called main function. And the fourth line is called return statement. Okay, these are the names of these lines in preprocessor directive. Now we will try to evaluate each and every line independently, individually, for getting its detailed introduction. What is the purpose of this line? This line is called preprocessor directive. The preprocessor directive is always start with the symbol hash. This indicate that this is preprocessor directive. This preprocessor directive line is normally used to add header files in project or program. And other important function or use of preprocessor directive, or we can say the type of preprocessor directive, is to define constant. In preprocessor directive, we are using to add library files in project, we provide the name of library file in angle brackets. As we can see here, there are the angle brackets opening and closing. In angle brackets, we have written name of the library files, which is named as iostream.h or iostream. In iostream, I stands for input, O stands for output, and stream means sequence. This may be the sequence of, we can for the time being we say that sequence of characters. Basically, this is the sequence of bits which will be forwarded by the program or the library file to input and output devices. In context of input devices, iStream means input, taking something from the keyboard. OStream means going towards the monitor or providing something to the output screen. Okay, this line is called namespace. This is the mandatory line in each and every C++ program. And the third line is called main function. We have to discuss in detail the main function and its purpose. Actual execution of the program in C++ basically start from the main function. Main function has some properties in C++. First property is that each and every program must have a main function. Secondly, program only can contain single main function, because this is the entry point of the C++ program. Here we can notice some arguments are provided in the main function. Don't worry about these arguments. We can also spare this space or arguments parameters list as void or nothing. This is the return type of the main function. And the line number 5 describes return. What will return from the main function? Because its return type is int, so that we are returning 0. Return what means return from main function? Whenever main function is launched or run or executed in a particular machine, after the completion of the program or application, it returns some value from the program code. If it returns 0, in some operating system it refers to the successful execution of the program. in any kind of exception or crash, the main function will return 1, which will indicate that the program is get crashed or have any trouble in the execution. Lastly, but not the leastly, this is the starting point of the main function, that is called opening delimiter. This is called ending point of the main function, which is also called closing delimiter. And accumulatively, these opening and closing delimiters are called body of the main function. I think much more clear demonstration or the explanation of these statements have been delivered. So let's move to the first, our first C++ program. What will the first C++ program in each and every books, writers, and everywhere on the over the internet, we say here, first program is hello world. Okay, this is just a single line, but for the beginners, we have to elaborate this line, this single line in detail. So let's start by explaining this line. This line is called output line, and it starts from C out, which is the part of standard namespace, STD, standard namespace. Here C out, it is read as, not read as cout, this is read as C out, has two parts. First one is called C and second one is called out. C means console and out means delivering or providing something. Accumulatively, this mean that console out, or we can say that console output. After this C out, this is called C out object. We see here two angle brackets or less than operators. This combination of two less than operator or two opening angle brackets is called insertion operator in C++, because console output C out object is going to insert something on the console output device, which is normally considered as monitor. What is going to insert on the console device, which is the parameter of C out, that is called hello world here. Basically, this hello world is the string which is written in double quotation marks. We can see here first one and second one double quotation marks. Whenever any string in double quotation marks is written, this is considered as constant, string constant in C++. Lastly, in the evaluation or elaboration of this line, we have to monitor a semicolon. A special symbol at the end of the line is given. This is called semicolon symbol. Each and every valid C++ statement must be terminated with semicolon. Okay, at the end of explanation of this line, I say that C out stands for console output, preceded by the insertion operator and any kind of string constant that will be displayed on the screen. Okay, now we are going to compile this code. For compilation process, dev C++ provide us two options. First, we may want to find errors and warnings, then we will have to compile this code using compile button. After successful compilation, we have to run this code using the run button that is adjacently available. If we want to compile and run in a single option, then dev C++ also provide us a control button that is called compile and run. Okay, I am going to compile the code to just see any kind of error if exist. In error log or console log, we see here compilation result in the bottom of the Dev C++ editor. Basically, Dev C++ editor is a IDE that is called Integrated Development Environment. Integrated means combined. Development environment means where we can write, compile means find our errors in the code and execute the code of lines. We can see here, it says that there is no error in the entire code. There is no warning in the entire code. The output file exists in the path and the output size is approximately this. Compilation time that it consumes is that. Means all stats relevant to the compilation provided in the compile log tab available in the bottom of the Dev C++. Now we are going to execute. After execution, we can say that after successful execution, we monitor that hello world is written on the screen. Now this is exercise for you. If you are also practicing with me real time, what is to exercise from your perspective? You want to write multiple lines, hello world, our name, country, blah blah, what will goes on in the code? We can write here C++ is higher level language. Okay, again we have to explain these line of codes, what it means, why we have write the second line of code, what it means, which are the similarities before line number 6 and line number 7. The first line number 6, I say that because here line number is available in Dev C++. Line number 6 is console output statement that will deliver or print hello world on the screen. Second line, we can say that is also a output statement that will deliver, this is line number 7, that will deliver an other output which is something different from the line number 6. The difference is only of string constant, provided we have written before, provided in single quotation, double quotation, sorry. Both lines are terminated by semicolons because both lines are valid C++ statements. Here I have to preview you a demonstration. If we does not or skip or omit semicolon at the end of the line, what will happen? Okay, let it check. We are going to compile the code. The code says that there is an error. What is the error? The error is listed here. What is saying? Error accepted semicolon before return statement. What is we say that? What is before return statement? Here is the another statement or C++ valid statement where we want to add semicolon, where compiler required that here will be the semicolon. Okay, compile it again. This is compiled successfully. We are going to run the code. Here we can see that our code is run successfully, executed successfully. First output is hello world and second output is C++ is high level language. Okay. One more important concept we have to clear that at that point. This will help us later in this entire video session. These two statements are written adjacently one after another. We can also write these two statements into a single line. लाइन नंबर सिक्स, लाइन नंबर सेवन कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन इन द सिंगल लाइन, लाइन नंबर सिक्स. दीज स्टेटमेंट विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड इन द सेम ऑर्डर इन विच दीज आर रिटन. नो विल स्किप, नो विल रिपीट मीन्स दिस स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्टेटमेंट इज कॉल्ड सिक्वेंस, सिक्वेंशियल स्टेटमेंट और सिक्वेंस स्टेटमेंट. दीज स्टेटमेंट्स आर एग्जीक्यूटेड इन द सेम ऑर्डर इन विच दीज आर रिटन. ओके, नाउ द प्रॉब्लम इज डैट, और द क्वेश्चन इज डैट वाई दीज लाइन्स आर डिस्प्लेइंग इन द सेम लाइन, बिकॉज वी हैव रिटन दीज लाइन इन टू डिफरेंट लाइन्स. Why these lines are not changing the line C out object? For that purpose, C++ provides us facility to end the line using end L manipulator. What I am written here, this is called end L, which means end of line. This stands for end of line. Now again compile the code. If we execute the code, line of code, we can see here hello world. C++ is a high level language, is displaying in two different lines. Okay, go to the code again. This code is also called source code, and the generated file, that is whose address is available here, output file dot exec, this is also called object code that contains information in binary form, which is easily understandable by the machines or computers. This is called source code that is easily understandable by the human beings. Okay, after successful understanding of the basic structure of C++ program, I would like to introduce concept of identifiers. What is meant by identifiers? What are identifiers? What are its purpose? At that point, I consider that all the viewers of my lecture have basic understanding of computer system, how these computer system works. The basic computer system phenomena is that it, first of all, it get input. Secondly, process input. This provided input, and lastly or thirdly we can say that generate output or provide us some output or provide us results. What is the concept behind discussing this phenomena in today's video session? The reason behind that, in each and every routine program or application or software, we monitor that it is taking some kind of input. If it goes to the ATM machine, it display a message, please enter your PIN number, and after message display, there is a section or box or getting input from the user. After this input, it process it and generate a some kind of output. So we will proceed these processes by using the identifiers. Now we tell you what is meant by identifier. Identifier is the name that is used to indicate some kind of variable, constant, or function. These are all called identifier, or it may also called class name, structure name, that are the advanced concepts of dev C++ we will later on discuss. First of all, we will discuss variable. Just remember in your mind that the basic phenomena behind the computation is to get input, process input, and generate output. Now we are going to declare some variable. Variable, what is meant by variable? Variable is a memory location in programming languages that is used to hold some data for processing or for saving the output of processing results. in C++ programming languages, we have to declare or define variables before use. The mechanism behind declaration or definition is that we have to specify data type of variable and variable name terminated by the semicolon. The concept behind the data type is required to be elaborated in detail. Each and every data exists in computer or exists in real world has some kind of type. Means that if we say about name, our name, it is string type data, collection of alphabets, or text type data. If we say that the age, it is numeric data or integer data without fractional point. If we say that height, let's suppose I say that my height is 5.7, then this is called fractional data or floating point data or real data containing decimal point. Similarly, other data exist and their corresponding types are also defined by the scientist or computer scientist. The syntax part, second part is variable name that is also called identifier. Here we have discussed identifier may be a variable name. This is called syntax of variable declaration terminated by the semicolon. The purpose behind the variables is to store user data during the program execution, save it. This variable, as its name is clear, that its value can be changed during the time of execution. We will discuss some basic data types in C++ available in our video session. The first one is int, that is used for integer values. Second one is float, that will use for floating point or decimal values. And third one is char, that is used to store the characters in program. Now just for we are going to create a variable that is called a. At that point I want to clear that variable name has some rules, or we can say that identifier naming convention followed by some kind of rules. These rules we will not go through the detail. Some key rules are as follows. The variable name should be the descriptive. What is it mean? You want to store the age of the given person or provided person or the robot or the machine or the person interacting with the software or application. We will use age. If we are going to save the temperature, we will use temp or temperature. If we use to save the password, we will use have password or pass. If we are going to save any kind of number or counter variables, we can also say that it is a. This is called variable declaration. At that point, I will have to clear again this line number 13 is the variable declaration. As we have discussed the syntax of the variable declaration, this is fulfilling the entire concept. First one is the data type is called int or integer. This is the identifier that is called variable name, and the statement is terminated by semicolon, which is also syntax part of the variable declaration. Okay, after variable declaration, we will use to store the values in that variable. Let's suppose we are going to assign a is equal to 10. It means that the value a 10 is going to save in memory location whose name is a. Whenever we want to access this value, we will just say console output a, and for the beauty of the output we say day and del. Go to the compilation and execute. We can see here 10 is displaying on the screen and then hello world and C++ language. This is called variable a. Its assignment statement second one statement is assignment statement, that is line number 14, and line number 15 is the output that is using to display the output of variable A. We can also create multiple variables in the single program. There is no limitation how many variables we can create or declare in a program. It depends on the requirement. Let's suppose we are going to declare more variables in our program, B, C, D, E, etc. As we have discussed, this is the declaration statement, this is the assignment statement, and this is the output statement. The next step is to store the result of the other computation or calculation into variables. Let's suppose we say that A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, and we say C is equal to A plus B, or any other arithmetic operation can also be specified here. Then after displaying the value of A, we can also display the value of C, which is the result of value A plus B. Here we will display the value of C. So let's compile. We can see that value of A is 10 and value of C is 30, because C is the summation of A plus B, where B is the 20 and A is 10. Okay. Now move forward so that we can quickly cover more topics of Dev C++ and C++ language. Now we are going to discuss the input methods or methodology that is adopted to take the input in C language or C++. This will call get input using C in object. Here we have assigned a static value using the assignment statement. This will never change. Each and every time we will write C out statement, the resultant value will be the 10. If you want to get input, some kind of input from the user, this is the common practice in each and everywhere where softwares or computers are implemented, that we interact with the user by getting input from the user. If we want to take input from the user, for this we are removing these lines. Basic understanding of these lines have been delivered to us. Okay, before getting input to the user, it is the best practice to display some kind of message that the user will be alert and more specific to provide you input. If we just get input using the input statement, then user will not understand or clear. Either it is standing in front of ATM machine, but I have to enter. ATM machine is requiring my name to enter, or my password, or my PIN number, or my ATM card number. So that we have to first of all specify the message that we are required to input. Let's suppose we are going, means by using cout statement, let's suppose we are going to take input in the A variable, so that we have to display the message, please enter your age, semicolon. This is the string constant or format string. This is the semicolon termination of statement. This is the console output. This is the insertion operator. Okay, this is already discussed in the previous 10 minutes, so we do not explain it again. Now we are going to take input using C in object of iostream.h class. So at that point, I have to explain what is meant by C in. As before, C out stands for console output. Similarly, here C in means console input, means getting. Console means, what is meant by console? Do not confuse the word console. Console means the devices that are commonly used for taking input and providing output from the computer system. These devices are console output devices, the monitor or display screen, and console input, standard input device, is the keyboard. C in means getting input from the console device or standard input device. And where it goes? It will go into the variable A. And what is meant by the operator? As before, we have discussed, these are the insertion operator, and this one, that is double greater than or closing angle brackets, are called extraction operator, that are used to extract out input from the keyboard console device. These two lines are elaborated. So let's check what is going on. We are compiling the code. Here is a message displaying on the screen. Please enter your age. What we will have to do, we will have to enter the age. Nothing is happening after this statement because we have not written any kind of statement, because programming paradigms or programming languages always follow the instruction given to the source code, given it right into the source code. If we want to display which input is provided by the user, we have to again write output statement, because we want to get the output or want to display the message provided by the input, we have to display here A. Here is a point I have to come to explain it again. As before, we have discussed the console output object of iostream.h, that is stands for console output cout, to display the output on the screen. Its input or its parameter may be the single string or text enclosed in the double quotation, or it also be used to display the value of variable. In that situation, it will fetch the value of variable, that is A, and display it on the screen. So let's check it again. This is again displaying the enter your age message. I have entered, let's suppose I am of age 30. The message is displaying that contains only the value of the variable. What will happen if we also write this A into double quotes as before in previous cout statement? What will go on? If you think yourself, then it is clear that this is not the variable. In double quotation, when we put it in double quotation, we have already discussed this is the string constant. Now it is the string constant, and constant always change. So that if we put the value of our age, let's suppose 12, it is displaying A, not the value of A, because now this A is not handling as a variable. This is treating as a, compiler is treating it as a string constant. Okay. If we want to beautify our code using the output message, then we can write here your input age is 12 or 30 or some, but input we can say here years. Okay, let's check the message and output. Enter your age, we say it 32. Oh, yes, this is now much more beautiful output of our program in the output console. Please enter your age. Your input age is 32. Now we are going to write down our first program, that is the mandatory for entire session, to exercise what we have learned. We are going to write a program. If we say that write a program that take, now we will discuss the problem solving technique, how we interpret the problem and how we have to write down its solution. Let us say write a program that input two numbers and display their sum. Okay, this is the point we have to study or we have to discuss with you in detail. This is the complete problem statement. Write a program that input two numbers and display their sum, or display their sum on the screen, etc. Here we have each and every program or problem we have to divide in three portion or three sections in computer science or in programming paradigms or getting solution of the problem from the programming languages. First of all, we will have to drive it into the input section. We can clearly see that write a program that take input two numbers It means we have to take input in two separate memory locations, and memory locations are handled by the variables that we have discussed before 5 minutes. We have to declare two variables because the input is required two numbers. And the second part is to display their sum. The processing is hidden in the word sum. We have to, what kind of computation we have to perform? We have to take two input variables and compute their sum, then we'll display on the screen. The word display is more comprehensive. It means to use the cout statement or print statement, whatever language we are using. In C++, we normally derive that write a program means write down the basic structure of program, that is include using namespace, hash, include preprocessor directives, take input, this in two variables. This section is handled with the help of variables, and display their sum. Sum is the basically computational concern phrase, and display is the cout statement concern phrase. We have to write down its answer. If we say that write a program that take input two numbers and display their sum, first of all we have to declare two numbers. Let's suppose this is A or B, or we can also say num1, num2. These are the two numbers. Here it is not specified that these two numbers of which name, or these two numbers of which description, num1, num2, etc. That's so that we can take any of the variable name A, B, B, C, C, D, num1, num2, so what we want. As we have discussed before, that our input should be descriptive, that our output message will be displayed before the taking input. Enter first number. Here we will use cin. We will have to specify the same numbers that is declared before the input and output statement. Here we will write down, or we can copy and paste for the sake of time. Enter first number. Here we will write down second number, and this will be the num2. What is the solution of the program? These lines are basically solution of that write a program that input two numbers, and the remaining part is and display their sum. As before I have discussed, that the computation lies here. We have to calculate the sum and display it on the screen. There are multiple ways to display the sum on the screen. I am going to just using the expression method to display the sum on the screen using cout statement. We have to display the sum. We write down sum is equal to num1 plus num2. Okay, compile it. The code is compiled and executed successfully. We can see here, enter first number. We enter this number as 12 and second number as 13. We can see here, clearly see here, enter first number. The descriptive message is, line is as similar we have written in the code. Enter first number, enter second number, and sum is equal to 25. This is the sum or computation. Now we have to come this point. At this point, what is going here? Now this is the third form of cout statement. We have discussed before, cout statement can contain format string or string constant as displaying in the output statement written before the sum statement. We similarly use this constant string in this cout statement, but additionally we are also calculating the sum or getting the addition of these two numbers in single cout statement. This is also third aspect of the cout statement that I will want to discuss with you gradually. We can use three syntax with the cout statement. The first one is cout, that is string constant and semicolon. First syntax is cout statement with string constant and semicolon. This string constant will be observed and compiled and output on the screen in same as it is written. The second is concept is with cout statement is cout with variable name. If we write down cout with variable name, then the variable name will not display on the screen. It will take or fetch the value of the variable whose name is specified here and display it on the screen. The third one is cout expression. If we write down the cout statement with the expression and semicolon terminated by semicolon, then the expression is not display on the screen. This, if we write down here double quotation and enclosed it in double quotation, what will goes on the screen? The expression will display on the screen. So let's check it as experiment. We say that 12, 13. We can see here sum is equal to num1 plus num2. Why this is occurring? Because we have converted expression into a constant string. We have to remove the double quotation marks to remove it constant string. If we use expression without constant strings, double quotation marks, then the result of the expression will be displayed on the screen. Result will be displayed. And here value of variable will be displayed. And here string will be displayed as written. I think this is much more clear that what is going on, how we can write program and how we can evaluate problem easily. What is meant by write a program? What is meant by, if we, it says that write a program that input three numbers, then it is clear that we have to declare three variables that will be used gradually. Enter first number, enter second number, enter third number. I have discussed before 20 minutes that these lines will be called sequential execution and executed in the same order in which these are written. The next step we are going towards after 30 minute lecture on basic understanding, getting the basic understanding of the C++ program structure, input and output statements. We are going to learn about the selection statement or selection structure of the C++. This is the sequential structure of the C++. Now we are going to understand what is meant by selection structure in C++, how it is implemented. In real world, sometime we have to make a decision on the provided input. Either one operation to be performed or second. Let's assume that we have an input. We have to start the function program. We take it input here. At that input, we have a finally decide which operation should be performed. Why which operation should be performed? Here we will put up condition that if this condition will be true, thus this statement will be executed. If this condition will false, then this statement will be executed. So let's consider the real world example. We have to comment or remove these lines. We have to just remove these lines. We have to consider the second problem. We say that write a program that take input and input, let's suppose a number, and check whether this one is even or odd. This is the problem. As we have discussed before, we will go through the same pattern. We have write a program that input a number. This is the first portion where it is decided that we have to take input a number where is the number is single and it can be handled using a single variable. Next part is the computation part that lies actually here. Either this number is even or odd, and we will have to display the message that is the final our destination or the result of the program. What we will have to do, first of all, we have to declare a variable that will use to take the input from the user. we say that cout enter number okay. The second line is we have discussed just for 15 minutes before cin statement. What these two lines will do, this will display the message what user have to do, enter number, and the cin statement will save get input from the user using in the extraction operators. These are the double greater than extraction operators, and save it into the variable that is of type int. We have also discussed the types, what is meant by type and what is meant by expressions. After taking the input, we do not require to sum, add, or multiply or divide as before previous example. In previous example, we will do the if statement. Here is the point to understand. For implementation of the selection structure, that structure that I have recently draw is called selection structure. For selection structure, notation. Here are some kind of statements. First one is called in C language if statement. Other is called if else statement. And next is called nested if statement. And last one is called switch statement. We will discuss these statements in today's session. First of all, we are going to discuss the if statement. Enter number. Number will be saved in A. We say that if A modulus 2 is equal to 0, then cout number is even. I have just write these lines of code. We have to discuss in detail because these are the important lines regarding with the operators and expressions. As discussed multiple times in this current session, this is the basic wireframe for the taking input from the user, declare, which involves three steps: declaration of the required variable, number of variables may be declared, displaying proper message for taking input so that the user would not worry about what is going on and which input I have to given to the computer, either age, password, number, personal number, etc. Then the cin statement will extract input or binary streams from the console device, that is called keyboard console input device. This is much more clear now what is going on in these three statements and what is its purpose. And the next statement is selection statement. Here the entire statements are called selection statement. What is going on here? This is the keyword that is called if statement keyword. This is as similar as English like language if. This is called condition or condition statement enclosed in small parentheses. These are the delimiters for the condition. This is the expression. This one is the expression. If A modulus 2, modulus will return remainder of the operands provided to the modulus operator. In this situation, 2 will apply dividend as the A, and the remainder will be the result of this expression. We already know each and everyone that if 2 completely divide any number, then it is called 0 completely. What it meant by completely divide? It means that the remainder of this number, given number by 2, will be equal to 0. Okay, clear it. If the result of this expression will goes to 0, then this equal symbol means to check the equality. This equal symbol is different from single equal symbol. Single equal symbol in C++ is used for assignment of a value to the variables or expressions result to the variable, and double equal sign is used to check the equality of the any operands. So it is clear that if its result is 0 and this is equal to 0, then the given number will be the even. In other situation, it will be the odd, not the even. Okay, let's check it by compiling the code. It is going to compile. We just have input enter number. We are going to input 14. Number is even. If we provide, this is clearly saying that number is even. Spell of number is missing, but it's okay. Number is even. What will goes if we provide any other number? We say that 13. We can see here no message is displaying on the screen. This is called limitation of if statement. Means if number or condition will not satisfy, or resultant will not, condition resultant will not true, then any other message will not display. In real world modeling, if we consider that if we goes to the ATM machine and it says enter your PIN number, we have to enter PIN number. If it is correct, then machine will display success message. And what will happen in computers also, we have enter PIN number or mobile, which is password. What is go? It display wrong message, wrong input, wrong provided password. Means there is also an alternate statement that will execute in case of false of expression. So that we have to follow, this is the example of if statement. Now we are going to follow the if else statement that will display the other message in case of condition will goes to false. If condition this goes to false, means its alternate will happen, means cout number is, what it says, number is odd. Okay, let's check it again. We say that if 13, it is saying number is odd. If we say that again, compile it, 12, number is even. This is called selection statement or if statement, if else statement in C language. There are other ways to check number even or using conditional operator, if else statement, nested if statement, or switch statement. We can also use nested if statement to check. There are multiple conditions that are interlinked with each other. We say that if we have two variables, we say that if we have two input and we want to check which input is greater or which number is greater, we just say that cout enter first number, then we will say enter second number, it will save in B. This is also a two dimensional problem in which condition is specified and two alternate outputs will be considered. We say that if A is greater than, we want to check the greater number, if A is greater than B, then C out A is greater. What will in case of else, we will say C out B is greater. Not to be confused with the C out statement. I again want to explore these C out statements in this block of if else statement. This is the C out statement written alternatively with the change of variable A and B. From that point, we have given to the variable name, so that in the syntax we have discussed before, so that here value of the variable will be displayed, and the is greater is a format string or constant string that will appear similar as it is written in the double quotation marks and terminated by the semicolon, this statement. Okay, let's check it again after compilation and execution. It says that enter first number, we are going to enter 12. Enter second number, we are going to 45. We can see here 45 is greater. This is the amazing features of the selection statements, selection structures, sequential statement we have discussed before. This is going to discuss the selection statement. What we will have to do if a programmer or user say that we have three numbers and we want to find out which number is greater out of these three numbers, similarly we have clear our vision, we will get third number as input and it will save in variable C. Now we have to check this expression using the nested if statement. We say that if A is greater than B, in if statement another if statement will be written. This is called nested if statement. And if A is greater than C, we write here, we can see that if A is greater than B, if A is greater than C, what will the greater? Here we can say that A will be the greater, is greater. In other case of is if else statement, what we will have to write down? We have to monitor it closely. If A is greater than B and A is not greater than C, then C is greater. This is the one part of the nested if statement for three variables. If A is greater than B but A is not greater than the C, then C is greater. If A is greater than B and A is also greater than C, then A is greater. What will go if this statement tends to false, A is not greater than B, then we will have to check B with C because it returns false only that situation B is greater. Then we will have to check B is greater than C. Similarly, we will have to write here C out. If this is true, we will write here A is greater. B is greater. If not B is greater than C, then similarly we will write here C is greater. This is called, this is somewhat tricky to implement nested if statement in programming. Not the difficult, but only a tricky technique to how implement nested if in C++. So let's check it after compilation. The code, we say that first one is 13, second one is 4, third and 67. We can see here the output says that 67 is the greater. This number sequence may be vary. This is not mean I have entered 67 at third so that it is greater. No, we can also say that 65 23 1, then it is also saying that the first input means 65 is the greater. Okay, let's move to the switch statement. We have to quickly move to the switch statement because we have to cover two more topics that are called functions and repetition structure in this session. The last selection statement is the switch statement that is used to choose one option out of the multiple options depending on the expression given to it. Let's suppose we have said that write a program that input day number and display name of the day. What we will have to do, write a program that input a day number, so that input a day number, so that we have to take input, single input, we say descriptive message, enter day number here, same statement day. This will be the descriptive if we write down the name of the variable day. These three lines are multiple times discussed in this single video lecture session. We have to implement here switch statement and provided the expression as variable name day. We say that case 1 cout Monday and break. Similar for other days. We just, for the time sake, will display only Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, Friday, etc. Okay, let's check it. After compilation and execution, case 1, case 2, it says that duplicate similar case, we have to change the constant of the case. Again compile it. This is compiled successfully. The problem occurs because I have copied it. If we say that 1, then the day is Monday. Compile and execute it again. If we say that 3, then the day is Thursday. Okay. This is concept is clear, much more clear. What is switch statement? This is also used to implement the selection statement, selection structure in C language. Now we are going to discuss repetition structure. Sometime in life we are required to repeat some task. Such as we have to place chairs out of the room one after another. We have to write down the counting. We have to draw the spirals. We have to count the notes. These are the repetitive structures that we have repeated and repeated multiple times the same instructions. This is called repetition structure. In C++, we can implement repetition structure using while loop. These are the called loops in language or C++. Implemented with the help of while loop, do while loop, and for loop. These three loops will be discussed in this session. What are its syntax and how these loops work? We are first of all declaring the variable a. The question is that why we are declaring the variable a? Because we have not asked the input of variable or sum of variable. This a is called counter variable. Each and every loop use a counter variable to take the track the count of the repetition. Let's start by discussing the first type of loop or iterative structure, that is called while loop. We say that while here we will have to provide condition a is less than or equal to 5. We will clear the idea of iteration or loop using this example. Now we are going to assign the starting value to the iteration. We know that each and every iteration in real world has some starting value and has some kind of increments or decrements to proceed the loop so that it may prevent from the infinity. We say that cout hello. This is the cout statement that is multiple times discussed before. We say here a plus plus, or this is alternate in C language, a is equal to a plus 1. Okay, let's see what happens or what is output is going to be displayed on the screen. We can see here 5 time hello is displayed on the screen. We can also display the number of counter variable with the output statement. As we have discussed multiple times in this video session, the output statement cout can also contain the variable name and it will fetch the value of the variable. So let's compile it again and execute the code. We can see here 1 hello, 2 hello, 3 hello, 4. If we want to modify this output to make it beautiful, we have to provide space before the code or format string. This loop is executed 5 times. What will we have to do if we want to display the hello 10 times? Then just we have to replace the end condition to 10. Now hello is displaying on the screen in console 10 times. Now quickly move to the explanation of the code or line of codes using while loop. Okay, close it. So let's start to discuss the entire code. This is the while loop statement. The first line is the declaration of the counter variable. of integer type, it will save the initial value and incremented value so that the loop can be controlled easily. The initial value, this is called iteration initialization, or first statement that will assign the counter variable its starting value. It may be one or any other. And this is the while keyword, while statement. This is the condition closed in the parenthesis, small parenthesis. And in small parenthesis, this is the expression that is called condition. Here we have write down while until a is less than or equal to 10, what will happen in that is the in body of the loop. This is the opening and closing delimiter that is called body of the loop. Here I have written cout statement that I have explained early. And this last line is called increment or decrement. So that we conclude that an iterative structure or repetitive structure or loop structure has three parts. One is called initialization, that is the starting value of the counter variable. Other is called condition, that is the while statement or do while statement or condition or expression, logical expression. And the last one is the increment or decrement. Other statement may be added in the body of the loop as per requirement. These are the fundamental three parts of the loop. So what is going on? We want to merge while statement or iterative structure with the if else statement to extend some example, such like if we want to write a program that input a number and display the starting and ending number of the input variable, or we can say that if we want to input a number and starting number and ending number from the user and display the string or numbers in between these numbers, and some example it may be using the if else statement. Write a program that display only even numbers from 1 to 10. The basic structure of the while loop will be the same. Here in while loop body we will say that if coming variable a inside the body of the loop modulus 2 that we have already discussed in this video session is equal to 0, then we will display cout number a. Here will be the endl, and in body of the loop while loop we have to say that a is equal to a plus 1. This is the increment statement. Save it, compile it, execute it. We can see that only even numbers are displayed on the screen. If you want to display only odd number, then we say that is not equal to 0, remainder with a given number, remainder with the 2, then it will only display the odd numbers on the screen. This is the emergence of while loop and if else statement. We can also practice much more programs. If we take in touch with our channel, we will say multiple type of programs in this section. You can also get knowledge of multiple programs, multiple programming techniques, multiple advanced concepts. This is only the course for the beginners to initiate or indulge in the programming using C++. Okay, the next topic after repetition structure is the function call or functions in C++. This is the second last topic in this video session, that is called function. A function, what is meant by function? Here is also example of the main function. Function means a named block of code that can be repeat according to the requirement. And other definition for the function is that modular programming. We can divide our large or huge programs into different small modules so they can handle and treat and debug and compile easily using modular approach. Here we are going to write down some kind of function to discuss its structure and syntax. Functions in C++. Basically, functions has three parts. One is called return type, function name, and in small parenthesis there will be the parameters. There is no range of parameters, how many type of how many number of parameters you can provide to the function. There are multiple, there may be multiple parameters in the function parameter list. Okay, let's define a function named as add, which will return sum of two numbers provided to the function. We have already discussed, we have already knowledge of different functions used in daily life or mathematics, such as sine, cos, tan, cos, leg, log, etc. Today we are defining our user defined function that is named as add. We say that here two parameters, int a, int b. Here are the two parameters of the function a and b. This is the function name, this is the return type of the function. We have to explore it. This is the function definition. This is called function definition provided before the main function. What will happen if we want to write it after the main function or inside the main function or outside the main function, before the main function, we'll discuss later on. This is the return type, that which type of data will be returned by the function, either it is int, float, character or any other. This is the name by which this function will be called. This is the number of parameters that it will take when this function is called. It is necessary to provide all parameters while calling of the function. And this point, these two delimiters are used to indicate the starting and ending of the function. This is also called function body. And this part of the line, I can say that this line is also called function header in the function definition. Okay, we just want to write return a plus b. As we have started in this video session, we discussed that the return is used to return from the function. Here also we write return a plus b, the simple line, but not a complicated concept functions. We have just write down the return a plus b. How we can call this function in main function? We say that int x, y, x is equal to 10, y is equal to 20. If we say that cout at x, y, what will in the output? We are calling here the add function. This is the fourth form of cout statement that we can also call a function that is returning some kind of value in the cout statement. I think it will have to return 30. Okay, this is returning 30. We can made it some beautiful output using the cout statement. We can say here sum is equal to add a plus b. Okay, notice here sum is equal to add a plus b. This is the function purpose and function use. The starting and the lines that will elaborate what a function will do are written before the main function is called body of the function. Here two parameters are provided, function definition. Here two parameters are provided in the function header that are called formal parameters. Okay. This one opening and closing parameter and in between the statements that are written are called body of the function. This is complete called function definition. This is function header, and three parts of the function header are discussed earlier: int, return type, function name, and list of parameters that are provided in small parentheses. And later on in C main function, we have called add function by its name provided by the parameters x and y. These parameters are provided using the variables that are declared x and y. Okay, these variables x value will be assigned to the parameter a and y value will be assigned to the parameter b, and later on a and b plus is returned to the calling of the function. These parameters that are defined in the function header of the function definition are called formal parameter, and the parameters that are provided in function call, this is called function call, are called actual parameter. Okay. This is the method basically that we can use to divide our program, large programs, into different parts, small chunks or small parts. The functions are also important or beneficial where we want to repeat over a task rapidly and we want to clean, keep neat and clean over main function code. The topics that I've discussed are written here. At the end, we will go through these topics again. Okay, the last topic is called arrays Our session's last topic is array that we will discuss. In the start of the lecture, we have discussed that we can declare multiple variables to save the multiple outputs. What will happen if we want to save 1000 inputs taken from the user and sort these out inputs or find sum or find minimum or maximum from the input? Then according to the today's scenario, we have to declare 100 variables or 1000 variables. Let's consider it again. If we want 100,000 values or input from the user, what will happen? Can we have declare 100,000 variables? That is a much more problematic and not a technical or not a suitable technique. For this purpose, we C++ introduce arrays. Array is a collection of memory locations that are combined under single name. Here I have written A in square brackets 100. This is the size of the array. How much memory locations are required? Each memory location is addressed with the help of its index. Array index starts from 0. What will it mean? If we write down int A 100, it means that there are 100 memory locations starting from A 0 to A 99. Okay, let's check it practically. We say that A 0 is equal to 20 and we want to get print of A 0 or first memory location. Then what is going on? This is successfully printing the value of the first element of the array that is called 20. This mechanism is used to process a large input or very large, extremely large input of the user. So we can compile the data, calculate the data, compute the data easily using single namespace. This is the single name under 100 memory locations. So we can drive it 100,000, 1000 millions memory locations under a single name. So the processing of the data is much more faster. We can output the data using for loop, while loop or iterative structure that will be much more helpful in processing the arrays. These are the entire fundamental topics that I have discussed in today's lecture, which include what is the basic structure of C program, what is the preprocessor directive, what is the use of namespace, what is the part of main function, why it is mandatory, how many main function can be written in the C statement. Then we have discussed C input statement, processing, output, variable names, memory locations, data type and variable name, variable declarations, common data types and much more other things that are included: selection statement, sequential statement, if else statement, do while arrays. These are the all fundamental topics that are mandatory to learn advanced topics or multiple other problem solvings or problem solution in C++. So keep in touch. We will come with a full course of the advanced object oriented programming later in next week. Thank you.